Hello and welcome to a stupid mouse review. I've got by a nice guy this Razer Boomslang 2100 and it's a ball mouse. I recall the last time I used a ball mouse is 10 years ago when I had all these Microsoft and TeleMouse Explorer 3.0 and they were breaking like once a month, once every 3 months by broken cable. And I was too lazy to fix it. And I used a really crappy ball mouse that had like a COM connect. Yeah, good old times. Okay, so let's test this. Let's put this good one aside. And use it. Yeah, what to say about the Boomslang? The Boomslang is quite a legendary mouse because it was like one of the first that's just produced, engineered for gaming. And I didn't touch this Boomslang yet, so just let's plug it in and check if it works. Okay, nothing is happening. Yeah, USB 2.0 did the trick. Oh. Now that's neat. It really seems to have 2100 DPI because it's pretty fast on my monitor. I think it's a bit lower than that, but yeah. Okay, let's hop right into a game. I don't want to. Well. Don't want to over-engineer that. I'm taking my training method I developed like 10 years ago. Good old Quake 3. Oh, this mouse is like, whoa, what the hell? Who the fuck designs this mouse? Okay, the DP is really too high. I'm always clicking the side button, the top buttons. I think you're supposed to use this like this, or it's rather like this. Whoa. Okay, the next problem we have is it's really sticking the balls, so I think it might be dirty. I already did stuff like this back in 98? It looks pretty sober here. Might be can't trick on this mousepad. Yeah, I think the mousepad has a bad friction for the boss, so. Okay, I don't think it's the mousepad anymore. I think it's. Think you're supposed to use this really high sense. So if it's not the mousepad, back with the pad. And let's measuring time. Okay, so. Ooh, that's like, 4 centimeters? 5? 5 centimeters for a 360. Okay, the next thing about the ball mouse, every ball mouse has a max speed. It's defined basically by the mass versus friction versus surface, and if you go too fast, the ball like jumps and you lose traction completely. Okay, so if it's this precise, it's all about. Let's go with default sense. Okay. Apparently that's no good. That's no good either. Well, this is about the precision you want to have.
Fight! Welcome to Freon. Prepare to take the lead.
Oh, this is a world of pain for somebody like me. at the same time, it's quite funny because... funny because I used to play with this super old ball mouse and I knew exactly it had so many problems with everything that I had to rely on like having a super slow sensitivity and a gigantic mouse access. So if I moved the mouse by 2 centimeters, nothing happened. If I moved it by 3 centimeters, I did a 180. That's another reason I'm using Quake 3 as testing. There's no mouse axle or anything else in the game. And even if I can turn it off, so... it's not as stupid as this whole new games. Okay, so the buttons on this mouse work quite good, by the way. The side buttons are a bit misplaced, but I like the big chunky mouse 1 and mouse 2 buttons. They just really do their job. Think this is the same sensation as if I would use up a gamepad, like an Xbox controller, to game a shooter on a computer. It's a bit better, I guess, but I really need to take care of... ooh.
Three frags left.
Now this is quite interesting. I can, if I do a slow aiming, it's like no problem. Okay, just look at this guy. I'm constantly aiming on him as good as I can. That's quite okay, I guess, but whenever I try to do a 180 or something, it's like super bad. I need to test something here. Jeez. Maybe I just need to get a grip on the mouse. Like, play with it for like 200 frags to know what it feels like.
Welcome to Freon. Prepare to fight. You have taken the lead.
Dude, this mouse is like, I think this mouse had just one purpose, and it's like high sensitivity gamers back in, no clue when it was developed, like back in the year 2000. The problem was, sooner or later everything was optical, and the basic optical mouse for every office computer or anything else was a Wii Mouse Optical, and after the ES Reality mouse score benchmark, the Wii Mouse Optical was rated like an A+ for gaming, thanks to the Microsoft MLT-04 sensor.
Welcome to Freon.
Basically, I would still use a Wii Mouse Optical if it wouldn't be for my excessive speed. This control feels so different to an optical sensor. I think I'm slowly getting the grip on it, but my accuracy still doesn't get up. So maybe just need to concentrate a bit more, like, don't do stupid mistakes. Like these ones. Okay, so I think something else is going on here, so I'm going to stop the record, download the driver, and retest. See you later. Okay guys, short interlude. I'm hitting the mouse up in the Innotus mouse software, and I use that one to calculate if the mouse really has like 2100 dots per inch. So I'm supposed to have the mouse. Hold the mouse button, move it by 10 centimeters. So again, because I was stupid. I'm moving it slowly because we know the ball could fuck up. That's about 10 centimeters and it's displayed as 2000 DPI. That's pretty good. So apparently it wasn't a problem with the driver or something, because the driver doesn't do shit. It basically just allows you to do some settings. It's neither a problem as with the buffer for USB, like the reason people are overclocking the WheelMouse Optical or the MX500, because the 8-bit buffer would be running full. Apparently it has a more powerful processor in it to just process all the data coming from the sensors doing the mouse wheel. So apparently this resolution is genuine. About the start, the speed, well, just know I'm hitting some, well, sometimes in Windows I see that my cursor just stops in the middle of the screen when moving from left to right. So I guess that's the ball that's not running properly, because if I move it very fast I can hear the ball and the pointer stops, and it's only stopping in the direction I'm moving fast. So if I move only left right and the pointer stops in the middle of the screen, the pointer still goes up and down because I'm not moving it up and down much, and this is very bad. It tells me a max speed of 0.17 meters per second on a nice resolution. So, well, that's bad. Okay, let's do a live test. I'm taking this mouse to a very old server in Quake 3. It's funny, this game is 20 years old and there are still people hosting servers for it. I mean, you could host one like at home and it wouldn't even matter. Since it's 2000 DPI, I don't really need to adjust much, because I need to move this mouse slowly anyways. If I go any higher, I couldn't deal with it. Well, let's try. Okay, now that's plenty high. That's plenty too high. This really sounds about good. This feels so horrible. Basically, I would have done this test like weeks ago, because we learned this mouse from somebody like 2 months ago, but I was a lazy boy. So I got into the smaller version of this video. Um, I also looked up when this mouse first went live. The first version of it was like in the year 99. So I'm not sure, but nobody had a good gaming mouse there, and Optical wasn't like even in business. So kudos for Razer for trying this.
Three frags left.
Seems this mouse has 2000 dpi, but is somewhat limited by not the ball. The ball is here, like just the ball, so it doesn't have any dpi settings. I think the sensors in have 2100 dpi, but the things that measure the ball don't, or they're just like very dirty. So somehow it feels sluggish even though it has 2100 dpi.
3, 1, fight! You have taken the lead. You are tied for the lead. You have lost the lead. You are tied for the lead. You have lost the lead. You are tied for the lead. You are tied for the lead. Taken the lead. Quad damage. Quad damage. Ha!
Can't believe I'm still first place. I would really like to open this mouse and like clean it, because if it has been like in 10 years of service, there should be dust inside blocking the sensors or something. But since it's not mine, we are not going to do that.
Left.
I can't believe I won that. It would have been easy on an optical mouse. But this mouse is not a competition to optical mice. It's a competition to ball mice, and it wins that. So yeah, what else is to say about this mouse? It's been a blast testing it.
Sadly, it's probably just this. You have lost the lead.
Few minutes or like 10, 20 minutes, I don't know. Video is still running. And I spent like 2 hours setting up a proper recording environment, optimizing the codecs, having extra light for the webcam, because turns out the webcam just doesn't do enough frames per second, you don't have an extra light on it.
You have lost the lead.
So yeah, I think that this is how you're supposed to use this mouse. You know a constant turning speed, and you use the same speed to aim with it. So probably you just have to use mouse acceleration. I'm not sure if I'm using basic Windows mouse acceleration or something else. I think I'm slowly getting the hang of it. So, with all mouse accelerations, this mouse is like seriously clapped because I can't turn fast enough and I can't pull the sensitivity low enough to aim with it. And somehow it feels a bit sluggish, so. Can't help it. Oh, I got zoom on mouse 4. Okay, enough of this. I don't think we need to test this on 500 Hz because it probably doesn't make a difference.